Bodhi, you are so cute. Look at him. He always sits and watches me. It's so cute because I feel like he's so aware. Oh, he's adorable. You're adorable, Bode.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is another Animal Answers. I'm really enjoying doing this series for you guys. This is the fourth episode in my Animal Answer series. Today we're gonna be talking about beginner reptiles. I get asked all the time, what is the best beginner reptile? And you guys use that phrase a lot whenever you ask this question, because there are a lot of people who are wanting to get a reptile or break into reptiles and are not sure which animal is perfect for them or which animal they're best suited to care for. So I get this question a lot and I wanted to address it here in an Animal Answer video for you guys. So first, let me start off by saying, just like any animal, whether it be a reptile or not, if you do not have the means, the money, the time to provide for an animal properly, please do not get it until you are able, until you've done your research, you can afford it, you have the time, the means, and honestly, the drive and the love to take care of it. Okay, with that out of the way, let's talk about best beginner reptiles. So whenever I see this question a lot of times, I see people wording it as, what is the best beginner reptile for me? And it's usually worded just like that. So I usually reply to people by saying, well, I don't know you personally, so I can't speak for you. I can't say what reptile is best for you, because I don't know your interests, I don't know how old you are, I don't know your history with animals, I don't know how much money you make, etc., etc. So there is no one-size-fits-all answer for that question. However, I can elaborate to maybe help you narrow down which animal is best for you personally. So if you're thinking about getting a reptile, let's just say hypothetically that you've been researching reptiles for a long time. You have the gist of overall what it's like to own certain reptiles, but you're wanting to narrow it down to just one. There are a lot of great questions you can ask yourself to narrow this down. The first question you can ask yourself is, do you have the time, the means, the money, and the availability to take care of an animal, whether it be reptile or otherwise? If you do, then obviously you can proceed with picking out an animal and figuring out which one would be best for you on your research journey. The second question you can ask yourself is, what animal are you interested in? That's something that probably seems pretty obvious. If you are a snake lover, like you're fascinated with looking at snakes, pictures of snakes, reading about them, watching them on YouTube, etc., then maybe start there and then research snakes and see if there is a snake that best suits you and what you can afford to take care of, etc. However, if you're someone who doesn't like snakes or you don't think you could feed mice, I know I'm one of the people that I don't have snakes because I personally wouldn't feel comfortable feeding mice, so it's not an animal that's best for me personally. So let's say you don't want to have to worry about it going off frozen, then maybe snakes aren't for you, and then you can start looking at other types of reptiles. A lot of times when people ask me this question, I know that they mean well and I understand what they're trying to say. They're basically trying to say in a roundabout way, what is the easiest reptile for someone who's never had reptiles before? But there is no one answer for that question. It really is so broad because it really does depend on the person. I personally think that crested geckos are an amazingly easy reptile to own. As long as you have the proper setup, time to care for them, you're okay with the fact that they're nocturnal, although they do require larger tanks, so you definitely have to have room for a really large tank for them. They are overall a very easy reptile to keep, and I think that most anyone who owns a crested gecko would probably tell you that. So in my opinion, crested geckos would be somewhat of a starter reptile for someone who is wanting to break into the reptile world. Or you're someone who truly has no interest in lizards or geckos or anything like that, and you would prefer something else like a snake, then a crested gecko may not be for you. It may be a great starter reptile for someone who actually would love to have one and wants to take care of one. But again, it's not one size fits all. So you really have to narrow down what is the best animal that you can provide a great life for, you can afford, you have the time for, etc. Now, with all that being said, I will say that I do love crested geckos. I love Bodhi. Bodhi is so fun. He's such a good little gecko. He is a rescue, as you guys know. He's about 10 years old. And I do think that he is a pretty low maintenance, easy animal to care for once you have the setup done perfectly. I really enjoy Bodhi. So if any of you are looking for options for a reptile and you're not quite sure what you want, but maybe you have been looking at a gecko or a lizard, If you are interested in crested geckos, I definitely recommend them. I think that they are awesome, but just be sure that you have the room to give them an enclosure. You have the time, you have the money, you're okay with them being nocturnal, and you've done all of the research that you need for their humidity and things like that, just to make sure that they are taken care of properly. But again, that goes for any animal that you could possibly pick, reptile or not. The list goes on and on, but it really does come down to your interests, your preference, what animal you believe you could give the best life to, and of course, as always, making sure that you research, research, and research before making the decision to get the animal in the first place. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Animal Answers and this brought some clarity to you if you are trying to decide what reptile you should get or if you're wanting a great beginner reptile or a starter reptile. I hope this brought you some clarity and will help you do the proper research to figure out which animal is best for you. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I will see you guys in my next video. Be kind.